chapter 2, what we did. What was the name of the chapter? Random variable, that is x, and discrete probability distribution. It was for discrete. Now this chapter 3 is for continuous variable. It means this value x can assume any value in a given range. Understood this? Pehle kaisa tha discrete tha. Do you know what is discrete? Number of kids in a family, number of flowers in a plant, number of road accidents. They are discrete. We can finitely count them. But what is continuous? Can I say temperature? Which is continuous, can assume any value. Then weight, age, can I say they are all continuous variables. So, first chapter of probability what we did was for raw data. Then second one was for discrete and third one is for continuous. Now, say for example, variable xi is given and pxi is given. This information is given to us. Now, if we plot them in a graph, where? Har ek word pe dhyan dena, nahi to sab mein pata hi nahi chalega. If we plot them, here we take variable x, yani xi ki jitni bhi values hai, we take it over here. And here, on y axis, we'll take p of xi. When we draw a graph, we get a bell-shaped curve. Now, at the peak, over here, mean equal to median equal to mode. Pata sabko, properties of a symmetric frequency distribution. Aisa properties of a discrete probability distribution or a probability distribution. Now, over here, mean equal to median equal to mode. Again, quartile 1 and quartile 3 are at equal distance. Ye pata hai sabko. Now, xi ka minimum value kaha aayega? On the left or on the right? Xi ka minimum value kaha aayega? On your left or on your right? On the left, there will be the minimum value, and on the right, it will be the maximum. Now, this complete area, what's the total? Total is always equal to 1. This complete area is equal to 1. This area is probability of xi, which is equal to 1. Understood this? Now, this moves towards infinity. So, infinity. Okay. Now, in this chapter, we want to find the probability for a continuous variable x. Now, usme hume kya karna hai? When you have a variable x, first of all, this x is converted into z. This is a variable x, and this is a standard variable z. This we call as a normal variable and this as a standard variable. Now, how do we convert x into z? Z is equal to xi minus mu upon sigma. This is the formula. X gets converted into z. Now this question comes, ki sir, kya zarurat hai ye karne ki? Now, in order to find probability over here, we have to use a table. Last page, yahan pe, there is a table which is written table of standard normal curve. It's table of standard normal curve. Yahan pe, on the left, you can see the value of z. On the right, yahan pe alag numbers diye, yahan pe bhi alag numbers diye. Now, we have to use this table to find out the probability. And for that, we convert variable x into variable z. Now when we convert x into z, this is x is a normal variable and z is a standard variable. Now when I convert x into z, from every value of xi, I'll subtract mu and divide by sigma. So ab ye jo xi hai, wo convert ho jayega into zi. Now if I plot this on a graph, if I make a graph for this, call it standard normal curve. If I make a graph like this, similar bell shape hi aayega, because x got converted into z, and based on z we'll find the probability. Now at the center point, what will be the value of z? Hum kya kar rahe? We are converting x into z. So at the center point, jahan pe mean hai, z ka value kya aayega? Z ka value kya aayega? Z will be equal to 0. Kaise? Because here it is mean. So mean minus mean upon sigma is equal to 0. Mean minus mean upon sigma. So at one point, this will become 0. Now over here and over here, what values will be over here? Positive or negative?
Negative.
Negative values, and over here?
Positive.
Understood this? Now, for every sum we do, we have to draw a curve like this, where z is equal to 0, this goes to infinity, and this goes to minus infinity. Understood this? Over here, if the value of z is negative, we'll plot over here. These are for negative values. This complete area, and this one is for positive values. So if negative, we plot over here. If positive, we plot over here. Then we'll have to do some shading, and then we come with the answer. Now, this complete area is what? Probability ka area hai. The probability is 1. So left hand side probability is 0.5 and right hand side probability is 0.5. You have to keep this in mind. Now what type of sums come in exam? Xi is given. You convert it into z. Use the table and find the probability. Understood this? Z is given. Find the probability. Any problem in this? Z diya hai, table mein dekho and find the probability. Another category of sums where probability is given. Find the value of Z, and from the value of Z, find the value of X. Pata chala kya karna hai? Now, what's the relationship between X and Z? Z is equal to xi minus mu upon sigma. You don't forget this. Is this clear? All of you understood this? X to Z and Z to probability. Probability kaise milega? Using table. Now same probability is given. Use the table, find Z. Once you have Z, values will be given. You find the value of X or the missing values. Understood this? यही दो टाइप के सम्स है. अच्छा, ये प्रॉपर्टीज याद रहेगा तुम्हें. मीन इक्वल टू मीडियन इक्वल टू मोड. डोंट फॉरगेट दिस. एंड दिस इज अ स्टैंडर्ड नॉर्मल कर्व. मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट, एवरी सम यू हैव टू मेक दिस एंड देन सॉल्व द सम. ठीक है? दिस इज 0. जेड इज इक्वल टू 0 कैसे आया? बिकॉज दिस इज मीन. मीन माइनस मीन अपॉन सिग्मा इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू 0. Since this is z is converted from x, all negative values of z, all positive values of z. Got it? Okay. Likh lo fatafat. page number 103. Illustration 1. A normal distribution has mean 10 and standard deviation 2. Find the probability of first normal variable x will take value between 10 and 12. Now when I say value between 10 and 12, there's a continuous, it can be any value between 10 and 12. Second, normal variable x has the value between 8 and 10. Now first let's write illustration 1, page number 103. Sabse pehle, mu, mean. Mu is equal to mean, which is equal to 10, given. Standard deviation. Is equal to sigma, which is equal to 2. Now first, probability of variable x, normal variable x, who takes value between 10 and 12. हम पहले ये करेंगे 10 and 12. I want to find the probability of x. ध्यान देना please, pay attention, don't miss out a single word. X greater than equal to 10, less than equal to 12. Now we convert x into z. So z is equal to xi minus mu upon sigma. I can take this as x1, I can take this as x2. Understood this? So when we convert this, we find the probability of x will become what? Z. X will become z greater than equal to 10 minus what is mu? Okay, we write mu upon sigma. Less than equal to 12 minus mu upon sigma. You understood this? Any doubt in this? Which is equal to probability of 10 minus mu is 10 upon sigma is 2. Z over here, 12 minus 10 upon 2, which is equal to probability of Z greater than equal to less than equal to. Ye kya ho jayega? 0 upon 2 is 0, 2 upon 2 is 1. Is this clear? Now, I'll draw a bell shaped curve. Z is equal to 0, infinity and minus infinity. For every sum, you have to draw this. Is this clear? Directly kar sakte hai, ye sab mein possibility hai. But, tumhe toh har ek mein karna hi hai. Now, 0, say 1, this is Z is equal to 0. Now, over here, ye jo hai na 0, can I say it is Z1? And can I say this is Z2? Okay? Now, 0, z is equal to 0 and z1 is also equal to 0. 0 se leke 1. Now, 1 will plot where? On the right or on the left?
Right.
Very good. So, somewhere over here, I plot z2 is equal to 1. Now, what region I want? I want the area of probability, which is more than 0. More than your right hand side? Number line concept yaad hai na sabko? Okay, more means right and less means left. So, common area. This is the area. Now, the equation is probability of Z greater than equal to 0, less than equal to 1. Now, we have to use table of standard normal curve. Come to the table. You can see this table. Now, sabse pehle you go to the heading. Kya diya hai? Z is equal to 0 to Z1. It means what? When I can see this table, I can see this table for an equation where one of the end is 0. Agar ye equation mein diya hota, so greater than equal to 0.5, less than equal to 1. फिर से बोलता हूँ, अगर ये equation होता, यहाँ पे 2 होता और यहाँ पे 1 होता, 1 to 2, we cannot use this table directly. If you want to use this table, one of the end should always be 0. Because diya heading mein, can you see the heading? Diya ki z is equal to 0 to z1, being the standard normal variable. Now, since we already have one of the end 0, so we'll see value of z2, which is equal to 1, is 1 kaha pe dikh raha hai tumhe? 1.0. What is the probability? 0.3413 is 0.3413. Therefore, probability of z greater than equal to 0, less than equal to 1, is 0.3413. And that is why probability of x greater than equal to 10, less than equal to 12, is equal to 0.3413 answer. Second, normal variable x has value between 8 and 10. So we have to find probability of x greater than equal to 8, less than equal to 10. Probability, now over here, x we convert into z. So probability of 8 minus mu is 10 upon sigma is 2. Z greater than equal to less than equal to 10 minus 10 upon 2, which is equal to probability of z greater than equal to minus 1 less than equal to 0. See, here it is minus 1 to 0. Okay, dhyan dena. If I draw a graph, z is equal to 0, infinity and minus infinity. Now, minus 1 ka plot karenge? Left side. Okay, so over here, z1 is equal to minus 1. Now, if you see the table which is given, वहां पे कोई भी नेगेटिव है, ऑल आर पॉजिटिव वैल्यूज. सो व्हाट डू वी डू? वेरी सिंपल, ध्यान दो. कैन आई से द एरिया माइनस 1 टू 0 विल बी सेम एज 0 टू 1? कैन आई से दिस, द एरिया रिमेंस द सेम? सो व्हाट वी डू इज वी कन्वर्ट दिस इक्वेशन, प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ z ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 0 लेस देन इक्वल टू 1. अंडरस्टूड दिस? Because table में 0 से 1 मिल सकता है, but minus 1 से 0 तो मिल ही नहीं सकता. Because the area remains the same, whether it is 0 to 1 or 0 to minus 1, it is symmetric. तो कोई फरक पड़ेगा नहीं. Therefore, using table, z1 is equal to 0.3413. Therefore, probability of x greater than equal to 8, less than equal to 10, is equal to 0.3413. Understood both? Understood both? अगर negative है तो क्या करोगे? तुम वो equation को change कर दोगे. Minus 1 से 0 will become 0 to 1. So the probability between 10 to 12 or 8 to 10 remains the same. Illustration 2, page number 104. A normal distribution has mean 20 and variance 16. Find the probabilities of 1. Normal variable x will take value less than 26. Normal variable x has value more than 14. Now, it's an open-ended thing. Less than 26 and more than 14. More than 14 can be anything. And less than 26 can be anything. There's no boundary. Now, first we write down mu, mean mu is equal to 20, whereas sigma square is equal to 16. Therefore, sigma is equal to 4. Don't forget this. We have to find probability of x which is less than equal to 26. We convert this x into z using the formula x I minus mu upon sigma. So we have to find probability of z less than equal to 26 minus 20 upon 4 is equal to probability of z 6 by 4, 1.5. This is z and this is z1. Now I draw a graph infinity minus infinity. At this point z is equal to 0. Z less than equal to 1.5. This 1.5 is positive. So kahan plot karenge ye 1.5? Right hand side. Very good. Now ye 1.5 says z1 is equal to 1.5. But mujhe area kitna chahiye? Less than chahiye. So kaun si side mujhe shade karna padega? Left hand side. Is this clear? Ab because left hand side hai complete, it will be complete like this. Understood this? Now the equation is z less than equal to 1.5. can we directly see the table? Can we directly see the table? No, because table mein kya likha hai? 0 to z1. Then yahan to 0 to z1 hai hi nahi. Is this clear? All of you understood this? So we cannot see the table. So what we have to do is we have to convert this into equation where one of the end is 0. Now, kaise convert karenge? Can I make out of this two equation? One is infinity to 0. And can I take a equation 0 to 1.5? Can I make two equations? All of you understood this? I want this complete area. So infinity se 0, to one of the end 0 a gaya. Or 0 se 1.5, to bhi one of the end 0 a gaya. Now, equation kaise banayenge? Now, very simple. Over here, minus infinity to 0. So I'll write like this, probability of z greater than minus infinity. Can anything be equal to infinity? Because we don't know what is infinity. So it will be greater than infinity, negative infinity, less than equal to 0. Ye pata chala equation. Achha, how do we make the equation? Very simple. Probability of, pehle z likh do, greater than equal to, less than equal to. Kya chahiye? 0 se 1.5. So here we write 0 and here we write 1.5. Got it, all of you? Now, what is this area minus infinity is a 0? What is this area minus infinity is a 0? So, which is equal to 0.5 plus 0 to z1. Use the table. What is the value? 0.4332. Using table. Which is equal to 0.9332. Equation kaise banana hai pata chala na? Okay, confusion ho, to pehle ye likh lo. And this to this, this to this. But infinity hai, so we cannot use equal. Itna yaad rakhna. Second is probability that the variable x will take the value more than equal to 14. Now we convert x into z, xi minus mu upon sigma. Therefore probability of z greater than equal to 14 minus 20 upon sigma is 4. Probability of Z greater than equal to minus 1.5. Negative 1.5. Can I say probability will remain the same?
Yes.
Final answer will remain the
same.
But how do we do it? There though. Now over here, draw a graph over here. Infinity minus infinity. Z is equal to 0. This is negative 1.5. So where do we plot, left or right?
Left
hand side. Okay. Z1 is equal to 1.5. This is greater than. Greater than. तुम देखो ये खुद बोल रहा कि ऐसे जाओ. देख रहे हो इसको. कौन सी साइड शेडिंग करो मैं इसका. Right hand side. Understood this? Okay. So. Got it? Now, we have to make two equations because equation mein one of the end should always be zero. So equation will be 1 minus 1.5 say 0 and 0 say positive infinity. How do we make the equation? Very simple. Probability of Z greater than equal to less than equal to, you first write this, minus 1.5 to 0. Plus
0.5.
We have to add probability of Z greater than equal to 0 less than infinity. Why less than? Because it can never be equal to infinity. Now I convert this equation is equal to probability of Z greater than equal to less than equal to 0 to 1.5 plus 0.5 using table, which is equal to 0.4332 plus 0.5, which is equal to 0.9332. Answer. Illustration 3. The number of students in classes of higher secondary school of a city follows normal distribution. Average number of students in the class is 50. So what is 50?
Mean.
Very good. And standard deviation is 50. If a class is selected at random, then find the following probabilities. First, a class consists of more than 68 students and a class consists of less than 32 students. Now first, let's write down what is given. X denotes number of students in a class. Mean mu is equal to 50. Standard deviation sigma is equal to 15. Now what we have to find first? Class of more than 68 students. Class of more than 68 students. In this case, we have to find probability of X greater than equal to 68. Now, X more than equal to 68. Now, we convert X into Z using standard scope, which is equal to Xi minus mu upon sigma. So, probability of Z greater than equal to 68 minus 50 upon 50. So, probability of Z greater than equal to 18 by 15, 1.2. Z greater than equal to 1.2. So I draw a graph like this. Infinity minus infinity, Z is equal to 0. Now this is positive or negative?
Positive.
Thank God. Now, सबसे पहले बढ़िया है, ये सबको पता चल गया कि ये पॉजिटिव है. वेरी गुड. सो Z1 इज इक्वल टू 1.2. अब ये क्या बोल रहा है? तुम इक्वेशन को जरा देखो. द इक्वेशन सेज z, the area should be greater than equal to 1.2. So if you shade this way, it is less than. So you have to shade it to the right. So it is this area only. Now to make this equation, ध्यान दो, मुझे ये एरिया चाहिए. So I'll take, ध्यान देना, 0 to infinity, I'll take as 1, minus 0 to 1.2. समझ में आया? 0 to infinity, minus 0 to 1.2, तो ये एरिया मिल गया. This is how we have to make the equation. You may draw arrows like this to understand the equation in the class or at homework, but not in paper. Understood this? So we write the equation, probability of z greater than equal to 0 less than infinity minus probability of z greater than equal to less than equal to 0, say 1.2. Now we have the answer, which is equal to, this area is 0.5 minus 1.2 is how much? 0.3849, using table, which is equal to 0.1151. Answer. Understood this, all of you? Okay, now second, Vyando, second class of less than 32 students. So probability of x less than equal to 32, we convert x into z. So probability of z less than equal to 32 minus 50 upon 15, probability of z less than, so minus 1.2. I draw a graph. Z is equal to 0, infinity minus infinity. कहाँ पे आएगा minus 1.2? Left. Okay, left hand side. Z1 is equal to minus 1.2. Arrow which side? Again left. So यहाँ से towards left. So I want this area. Now, what will be the equation? It will be minus infinity to 0 minus minus 1.2 to 0. Understood this now? Understood this? Phir se ek baar. Now I want this area, but one of the end should be 0. So minus infinity say 0, minus minus 1.2 say 0. So ye area reh gaya. So we make the equation, probability of z greater than minus infinity less than equal to 0 minus probability of z greater than equal to minus 1.2 less than equal to 0. But we cannot have this negative, so we convert this into positive. So probability of z greater than minus infinity less than equal to 0 minus probability of z greater than equal to 0 less than equal to 1.2, which is equal to 0.5 minus 0.3849, using table, is equal to 0.1151. Answer.